Hello everyone, welcome to the session. I am Mr. Pravin, Yalappa, Kumbhar. Today we want to see system design examples. The learning outcome of this topic is, at the end of the session, student will be able to explain the concept of system design in satellite communication. The contents of these topics are, first, introduction, second, system design example. Introduction. The following system designs demonstrate the ideas can be applied to the design of satellite communication system. This table shows Ku band satellite parameters. For design of a satellite, we require Ku band parameters. Now, whenever we design a satellite, we require uplink as well as downlink parameters. This is a transmitting Ku band earth station. This table shows the different parameters and their values. This table shows receiving Ku band earth station. There's different parameters and their values are as follows. For designing of a satellite system, we require rain attenuation and propagation factors, and the different rain attenuation and the propagation factors for the uplink as well as for the downlink, their different parameters are shown in this table. Now, we want to see system design example. Question: the design of a satellite communication link using a Ku band geostationary satellite with bent pipe transponder to distribute digital TV signals from an earth station to many receiving stations throughout the United States. Now, when you read this question, here we want to design a satellite communication link in the Ku band in the US. Now, we want to design the system. For design of the system, there are two steps we require. The first step is Ku band uplink design and Ku band downlink design. Now we see one by one Ku band uplink design as well as Ku band downlink design. First, Ku band uplink design. For this Ku band uplink design, we require design of uplink noise power budget, the antenna gain, the free space path loss, uplink power budget. For the Ku band uplink design, when you calculate all these four things, then the uplink design is done. Uplink noise power budget. Everyone here, pause the video and recall the noise power formula. The transponder noise power is equal to N. That's formula is N is equal to K plus TS plus B, that is equation number one, where K is a Boltzmann constant and that's value is -228.6, that's unit is dB watt per Kelvin per Hertz, where TS is the receiver system noise temperature, that's value is 500 Kelvin, that is the Kelvin is converted into the dB Kelvin, and after the conversion of this 500 Kelvin into the dB Kelvin, we get 27 dB Kelvin. B is the receiver IF noise bandwidth, that's value is 43.2 megahertz, that convert that megahertz into the dB hertz. After the conversion of this megahertz into the dB hertz, we get 76.4 dB hertz. Now put these values into the equation number 1, we get transponder noise power is equal to -125.2 dB watt. But whenever we received the power at the transponder input, that must be greater than the 30 dB than the noise power. Therefore, we add this 30 dB into the equation number 2, we get transmitted noise power as -125.2 plus 30 is equal to -95.2 dB watt. Now, we want to design the antenna gain. For that antenna gain, the formula for the antenna gain is GT is equal to 10 log 0.68 into pi d by lambda bracket square. This is equation number 3, where d is the uplink antenna diameter, that's value here for the design of this antenna gain, we take here 5 meter. The wavelength is equal to lambda is equal to 2.120 centimeter, But now for when we design this antenna again, we convert the centimeter into the meter. After conversion of the centimeter into the meter, we get 0.0212 meter. Now put this value into the equation number 3, we get the antenna gain is 55.7 dB. Now see the free space path loss, that is LP. Now the formula for that free space path loss LP is equal to 10 log 4 pi r by lambda bracket square, that is equation number 4. After the putting the value of r and lambda, we get LP is equal to 207.2 dB. Now D, uplink power budget. The formula for the uplink power, that is PT, is equal to GT plus GR plus LP plus LNT plus LM. That is equation number 5. Before solving this one, we want to understand what is the meaning of the E term and what is the value of the E term. Now first, that is a PT, that is the earth station transmitted power that we want to calculate here. GT is the earth station antenna gain, that is 55.7 dB. GR is equal to satellite antenna gain, that is 31 dB. LP is the free space path loss, that is minus 207.2 dB. LANT is equal to E by S on 2 dB contour, that is minus 2 dB. LM is the other losses, that's value is minus 1 dB. After putting this all these values into the equation number 5, we calculate earth station transmitted power, that is PT is equal to minus 123.5 dB. Now we want to design KU band downlink design. For the KU band downlink design, we want to solve the first, calculate the downlink, that is C by N downlink. Second, calculate the required received power. Third, calculate the path loss. Now we want to calculate first, calculate the downlink, that is C by N downlink. Before the calculation of a downlink, we know the formula 1 by C by N down is equal to 1 by C by N 0 minus 1 by C by N up, where C by N 0 is overall C by N ratio, that is 17 dB. After the conversion of dB into the normalized function, we get that value is 50. C by N up is equal to 30 dB. To convert this decibel into the normalized function, after conversion of this dB into the normalized function, we get 1000. Put this value into the equation number 6, we get 1 by CN down is equal to 1 by 50 minus 1 by 1000 is equal to 0.019. That is 1 by CN down. Now CN down calculated by 1 upon 0.019, that is 52.6. This normalized we again convert into the decibel. After the conversion of this normalized into the decibel, we get 17.2 decibel. Now we want to calculate required received power. For that, the formula is PR is equal to N plus 17.2 dB. That is equation number 7. But before the calculation of this received power, we want to calculate the first N, where N is a transponder noise power and PR is the power at earth station receiver input. Now the before calculation of that one, we want to calculate first N. The N is equal to K plus TS plus BN, where K is a Boltzmann constant, that's value is minus 228.6 decibel watt per Kelvin per hertz. TS is equal to 140 Kelvin. After the conversion of this Kelvin into the decibel, we get 21.5 decibel Kelvin. BN is a Boltzmann constant. Here 43.2 megahertz. The conversion of this megahertz into the decibel hertz, we get 76.4 decibel hertz. Now putting this value into the equation number 8, we get N is equal to minus 130.7 decibel watt. Therefore, the received power PR is equal to N plus 17.2 dB. After the putting the value of N into the above equation, we get PR, that is received power, is equal to minus 113.5 decibel watt. Now, calculate the path loss. For the calculation of a path loss at 11.45 GHz, before the calculation of a path loss is this for this frequency, we know the first frequency is at the 14.15 GHz. At that frequency, path loss was 207.2 dB. From this frequency, we can calculate the path loss at this frequency. For the calculation of for that frequency at 11.45 GHz, path loss is LP is equal to 207.2 minus 20 log base to the 10, 14.15 divided by 11.45. That after the calculation of this thing, we get path loss equal to 205.4 decibel. Now, downlink power budget. The transponder is operated with 1 dB output backoff. So, therefore, PT is equal to 19 dB watt minus 1 dB is equal to 18 dB watt, that is a downlink power. And the receiver power PR is equal to PT plus GT plus GR plus LP plus LA plus LM. Now, where PR is the received power at transponder, PT is the satellite transponder output power, that is 18 dB watt. GT is the satellite antenna gain, that is 31 dB. LP is the free space path loss, that is minus 205.4 dB. LA is the E by S on 3 dB counter of satellite antenna, that is minus 3 dB. And the LM is the other losses, that is minus 0.8 dB. Therefore, put this value into the above equation, we get PR is equal to minus 160.2 dB. The references for this topic is. Thank you.